Okay. First of all, I want to thank Dr. Miller, and of course, the entire department of the Hispanic Authority for this invitation. So it is a big pleasure and honor for me to be here with you, all of my friends, okay? Okay, the quotation in this paper, first of all, this was an essay written in Spanish. It was 20 pages essay that I reduced to 8 pages in order to read it here. And it was originally in Spanish, and the quotation, I keep it in Spanish because I wrote those books in Spanish, so. The rest is in English. The politics of immortality in the clay series that's real. In the preface to Poets and Poems, Harold Bloom indicated that, I quote, "I accept only 3 criteria for greatness and imaginative literature: aesthetic splendor, cognitive power, wisdom," unquote. According to Bloom, those 3 terms are the cut hand that all artists must wear in order to enter to the kingdom of canon. The aesthetic splendor corresponds to the life of the artistic forms, what it makes of the art a singular human manifestation. The cognitive power is associated with the artist's ability to grasp the knowledge given by tradition and by their own experiences. Finally, of these 3 categories, wisdom is the one that entails the greater load of memory and futurity. Therefore, wisdom is installed in the future because it contains the accumulated knowledge by group, nation, or culture, and simultaneously, it announces the path that culture and art will be discovering. Now, if we rely on the categories given by Bloom, and we consider them like the ones that condition the value of, an artwork, therefore, we must think the relation that all artists settles down with his tradition. Relation that goes from the regional level to the universal one, and vice versa. Following this idea, we could argue that by doing literature criticism is to place in its historical and artistic context the aesthetical imaginary that supports the creation of each writer. In this way, we could weigh its actual range and display whether or not this creation transcends spatial and temporal bonds in which was conceived. The power of imagination depends of the artistic force that maintains, and it depends of the mind able to elaborate it. In addition, this force is measured in as much as managed to stimulate the successive generation to rethink the canon, the tradition. This is why every artist is a kind of savant. As well, there are 2 types of artists. One, the provincial one, which only reaches the visibility within the limit of his village, whether geographical, artistic, or mental, and the ones that emulate Alexander the Great and becomes conqueror and launches to the occupation of worldwide imaginary. Those writers who create their world through cycles of historical novel and whose artistic will is to investigate in the history of a group or nation, they build a very interesting relationship as much with the microcosm and with the microcosm and the microcosms where event and character of their artworks are developed. Writers like Balzac recreate their society from the individual life of the characters. Some others, like Stendhal, create narrative spiral that went from macro to microcosm and then came back to the macro again. Both ways of intellection are forms of investigation of the human condition expressing itself in history, or how history affects the human condition. Rolando Jose Smith, author of the novelistic cycle, Clay City, Death Trip, is one of the contemporary writers whose work allows, on one hand, to rethink the three categories that Bloom demands to all creators, and on the other hand, go over the relationship that the writer has with his tradition. Hinojosa's case is a very distinguished one in the measurement that is an author of borders, from the language perspective between Spanish and English, from the geographic point of view, he was born in Texas, lower Rio Grande Valley, and from the literary perspective. His work is connected by multiple influences that belong from the Hispanic literature, as much as the American literature and to few present Chicano literature that had when Hinojosa started writing. In the following pages, we will study how Hinojosa responds in a particular way to Bloom's category of value. Also, it will be analyzed the relationship Hinojosa established with the tradition mentioned before. To get to that point, we will find support in an idea from the contemporary German thinker, Boris Groys, developed in his book Politics of Immortality, according to which all great artists practice a rule that goes beyond the common political convention of the rest of the human. To Groys, his concept of politics goes further the historical frame it does belong, because its main purpose is to reformulate the tradition and to awake the restlessness and passion of the future generation. Ahead of the two detective novels, Partners in Crime and Axe a Policeman, that make up Plague City District, let us think the totality of the novelistic cycle as a trip of investigation. That is, a search that operates in two levels. One, an artistic and ontological investigation, and number two, a political and historical scrutiny. Both levels present since the beginning of the Western culture with the Iliad and Odyssea, come together until conforming the journeys common to the great art worlds. Those journeys are, number one, the journey to conquest of otherness, and number two, the passage of return home, the origins, which is a passage toward the spiritual enrichment that the origin by itself it does not provide to us. Since Estampas del Valle, we are in front of a detective composition at a structural level of the world. Let us think the structuring of this novel in the following way. The author, Hinojosa, is a detective from whom the successive stamp and part of the book were abstract to unravel the case that is persecuted. Likewise, the book is a word table where the tracks, stamps, are ordered by the investigator. Then, from an order in appearance arbitrarily, disorder, a harmonic totality is reached. Tiny life of several families create a larger body, which is the one of the first inhabitants, founders of Belkin County, and their successive life or, quote, trips toward the death, unquote. In addition, the constant change of the narrator from omniscient to tales narrated in first person, they would come to work like the different point of view with which all detective counts to arm the puzzle. On the other hand, the four parts in which Estampas del Valle is divided, they work like different angles of the passage of time. The polyphony that sustained most of Hinojosa's novels would be the multiplied voices of the witness who are telling the author, the detective, the general story in which the micro stories are developing. But which is then the case that the author must solve? We could venture an answer and argue. The case that there is to rebel in Estampas del Valle and by the extension in Clay City District is this one: to find a place in the world to this group of men. From the values that they profess, the action that they undertake, the path they are living in the generation that will be succeeding. Nevertheless, the writer makes literature. And for that reason, he knows that to be able to find a place in the literary world, he must be inserted in a literary tradition. The memory of the humanity is possible thanks to the literary archive. The idea to think history as writing is more suitable than to think it within the strict limit of a veracity. That happens in the work of Rolando Hinojosa. More than the 25 characters that make up Estampas del Valle keep a lot of connection with some canonical character of the Western literary tradition, mainly Hispanic and American. As a consequence, we see that there are echoes from La Celestina, Don Quixote, from the national episode of Benito Pérez Galdós, from the human comedy by Balzac, from Los de Abajo, de Azuela, from certain Juan Rulfo's town, from Santa Maria City, imagined by Juan Carlos Onetti, from Macondo, region created by Garcia Marquez, and from Jonathan Pau, coined by Faulkner, from El Lazarillo de Tormes II. I open quotation. Conocí la muerte y su finalidad cuando no había llegado yo a los 7 años de edad. Ocurrió una tarde de tantas cuando volvía de la escuela. Las vecinas no me dejaron entrar en casa y me despacharon a una banca que se encontraba cerca de la barbería de Gelasio Chapa. Ahí lloré hasta que vinieron por mí para que me fuera a dormir. Por papá no pregunté hasta el día siguiente. Me avisaron que llevaba 2 días en la cantina de Cano y que sería mejor si no fuera a verlo. Así fue. A mi mamá la enterramos no muy lejos de San Pedro y la visitaba cada mes con papá hasta que él también se murió así, de repente, sin aviso, mientras me contaba un chiste. Un chiste que ahora, 25 años más tarde, todavía no me he podido acordar de qué se trataba. Cuando él murió, yo tenía unos 9 años y tocó la casualidad que el día del entierro llegó lo que nosotros llamábamos las maromas. Un quote. The previous quote allows us to see the literary tie that Hinojosa made in his novel in order to determine the proportion of his characters. To give them life in the literary fiction, which is the reason that after all insufflate life to everything beyond their worldly and ephemeral condition. In this case, the picaresque life of Jehun Malacara places this character in a canonical tradition. So that it validates him in an artistic way. Hinojosa is telling the history of his group through that artifice. Each character has a reminiscent shade that validates him in the millenarian memory of the humanity. In another level, the multiple narrative techniques, inner dialogue, change of narrator, spatial and temporal flashback, etc., and the several literary gender, novel, drama, poetry, short stories, epistolary gender, etc., that cross and support each volume of Clay City, the Street. They reinforce Hinojosa's will of giving transcendent life beyond their ephemeral condition, but giving the necessary significance to that secular nature. In their daily act, the character of Clay City District establish, accept, and put into play their ethical values. These values soon undertake a journey to engage in a dialogue with the other values that the tradition has imposed. Therefore, we read in the initial page of El Condado de Verger, cito, I quote, aquí aparece gente que ya se ha ido en otras ocasiones, gente que apenas se ha mencionado y todavía otra gente que se conocerá. Este mundo de Bergen County es un ir y venir. La gente que nace y grita, también llora y ríe y va viviendo como puede. Unos suben, otros bajan, pero al fin todos mueren y al llegar la hora de la hora, aquí no ha pasado nada, señores. El muerto al pozo y el vivo al gozo, si se puede, sin que le cojan a uno con las manos en la masa. Aquí no hay héroes de leyenda. Esta gente va de excusado, estornuda, se limpia los mocos, cría familia, conoce lo que es morir con el ojo pelón, se cuartea con dificultad y, como madera verde, resiste rajarse. El que busque héroes de la proporción del Cid, pongamos por caso, que se vaya a la laguna de la leche. Verdad es que hay distintos modos de ser heroico. Jalar día tras día y de aguantar a cuanto sonso le caiga a uno enfrente no es cosa de risa. Entiéndase bien, el aguante tampoco es cerrar los ojos y hacerse pendejo. Un quote. In the prior quote, all thought a distance is taken from the heroism of El Cid, it is the heroic gesture that comes from the simple action of men. As we can read, I quote, hay distintos modos de ser heroico, jalar día tras día y de aguantar a cuanto sonso le caiga a uno enfrente, no es cosa de risa, un quote. We are in front of a journey that enters in the world illuminated by the light of modernity, in the capacity that is advancing in its narrative development. Here comes the idea of a journey of death. While the time passes, the values and codes of those claros varones are erased and died. If those values are still recognizable, they are in characters, Jehu, Rafa, Becky, that in their development have established deep bonds with the learning and way of life, with the miseries and greatness implanted by their ancestors. All thought in Hinojosa characters are not of the dimension of the Cid, that is, epic ones. In fact, they are characters with a strong roots in the great Western literary tradition. The specialized critic placed the Clay City district within Chicano literature. This is certain until a limit. He himself, Rolando Hinojosa, has been recognized in this tradition. His first intention is without a doubt to give visibility to that human world. But we do not have to be confused. The work of Hinojosa reached such level of literary elaboration comparable to some of the pillars of the Western tradition that to reduce it to lo Chicano, he could not reveal the true reach of its writing. What is suggestive in Hinojosa's literary project, it could be possible to be translated in the following question. How the volume of the Clay City district goes beyond any label? What is beyond all those paraliterary marks that without doubt have the writing of this book? Perhaps we can find a possible answer in the theory of Boris Groys outlined in the beginning of his essay, This is a Politic of Immortality. According to Groys, all great artists make art by the will of being inserted within the historical archive of art. The task of the artist is becoming archive, devenir archivo in Spanish. The politic practice by politicians is inherent to the space of polis, but the one from the artist is a politic of immortality because implied a bidding to access to the archive. The true fight of the artist is against death and not against the alive ones. As much against the departed dead, los muertos muertos in Spanish, those that already physically had their earthly life, and those dead that at some point, at some time of history will be alive. That is, those who are still to be born. The artistic battle of the creator is not in the polis, it is in the cemeteries, in los cementerios. A politic of immortality results an among grave, in Spanish it's like práctica de entre tumbas, practice. The battle of being part of the archive happens in the house of the dead. According to Groys, it makes no sense that an author writes to, I open quote, un montón de personas sobre las cuales cabe suponer que en un momento no tan lejano estarán todas muertas. Ya por esta única razón carece de sentido escribir especialmente para este público. Y como autor actual, uno no sabe realmente cuán envenenado y viciado está el aire que respira diariamente el público de hoy. Por eso, la única posibilidad que le queda a uno es la de dirigirse al lector que no existe, al lector utópico, imaginario. A project like the Clay City District practiced a politic of immortality. The ideological relevance that the Chicano has is just a background element in Hinojosa's work. Beyond some reflection of the fight by the right of the Chicano present in the Clay City District, it is not the will of the, of the author to reduce his literary journey to the defense of a specific ideology. In fact, in the Clay City District, we are not in front of Manichaean point of view. From the old revolucionarios who decide to make their life clavar estacas from this side of the river, and from the first claros varones, we notice that the treatment of the human condition goes as the narrator said. Open quote. Son y están como las greñas de Mencho Saldaña, unas cortas, otras largas, y todas embadurnadas con esa grasa humana que las junta y las separa sin permiso de nadie. Un quote. The last pages of Claros Varones de Belkin result an example of the idea exposed in the previous paragraph. Esteban Echevarría distinguished the death of that original world created by the founders of La Raza. I quote. Casas sin corredores, calles sin faroles, amigos que mueren, jóvenes que ya no hablan español ni saben saludar. ¡Hey! Desaparece el valle, gentes. Los bolillos con sus propiedades, sus bancos y contratos, ¿sí? Gente que no reconoce un choque de manos como cosa legal. Farmacéuticos con título, pero sin experiencias en la materia, rancheros que no labran y pueblerinos con corbata. ¿Para qué le sirve a uno vivir 83 años si todo lo que uno vio nacer está enterrado? Los vilches, muertos, los tueros, también. Los buenrostros se acaban y las familias fundadoras se secan como las hojas del mezquite doliente. Un quote. But a few more pages pages ahead, Echevarría says, I quote, buen árbol el mezquite, duradero el mezquite con su sombra rala y a veces espesa, un árbol aguantador como la raza. Un quote. That is to say, here we are in front of a way to understand the world and the human relation that are constantly corrected with the purpose of reflecting a human nature in the most realistic way, full of light and shadows. That buen árbol el mezquite, aguantador como la raza, refers as much the human group that Rolando Hinojosa had the will to perpetuate as the threat of literary imagination in which la raza goes towards its death. In order to practice the politics of immortality, that is, in order to be more than a paraliterary mechanism or level, but a self-sufficient literary phenomenon in itself.